services part of it, because if you see, and henceforth, guys, now you are in third year, you are exactly in the center of your architectural education. Okay. Now onwards, all you are going to do is on a heavier side of buildings. Okay. All that domesticity and small scale architecture is now first and second year. From now onwards, either you are going to do institutional buildings on a, at an urban level. Next year, probably you're going to do that. And this year, you are going to do at a little lower level, but still it is larger than what you did in your second year. And so obviously, when we say that you are going to do something for public, something institutional, or in fourth year, you are going to study high rise. And in the final year, probably all that amalgamation of services that you did in your 5 years will be, you know, put to use in your thesis. But then what I'm trying to say here is, henceforth, service is going to be a part and parcel of your design. Because as I say, 35 to 40% of your built-up space is services. Whether you like it or you don't like it, you don't have an option. Okay. So better you like it and design it along with your spaces. The best part is in any of the brief that you get in design competition, and I would strongly urge all of you guys, has someone started recording?
Yes, it has started.
Okay, fine, great. And I would strongly urge all of you to go and see some of the competitions that are there on site. There are lots and lots of architectural competition floating around, and you can see some of the briefs put up there. And you can see all the briefs will talk about a conceptual idea, or the theme around which the, you know, the whole building is to be planned, okay? So they would give an idea about the spaces they are imagining it. But they take it for granted that a well-educated, a sensitive, sensible architect will provide spaces which are functional. Of course, they are beautiful by default, because that's why the designing and space designing comes into the picture. So by default, they assume that the building will be good looking. Okay, so that is given. But just good looking doesn't help. Na? Then there are other layers that one has to add on. Like in second year, you did all the climatology. So a good looking factor would come into the picture. And then Jimmy last time, first time spoke about regional architecture, vernacular architecture, where the climatic, strong climatic concern comes into the planning, and then it kind of gives you the regional architectural feel, you know. So whether you are designing an auditorium or a high-rise building, depending where you build, what kind of material, what kind of climate concern you take, accordingly the language of the building will evolve. So taking all this into consideration, but none of the brief speaks about services, ke itna toilet dalo. Itna wall to window surface ratio hona chahiye. This should be the shape, and why this shape should be there, or this form will allow this kind of ventilation to happen. That is for you to arrive at. That will be your strategy. The services will be the driver, and exactly that is what I'm going to do on Wednesday if we take the lecture. Hopefully we take the lecture, but otherwise we were planning not to take it because it's your submission, so we probably will need more time to interact with you. But it depends, okay? Right now, we are going ahead with the lecture, assuming. So that's exactly what I'm going to speak on Wednesday, where services become a very strong driver for the form of the building, okay? And not just something to be hidden about, to be something about, you know, depressed about, oh God, I have to do this. It is actually the hero of the building, you know? So with the acoustics, this is one of the things that one has to remember. And services will play a very important role in all your auditoriums, because half of your services, sorry, of your spaces are going to be this. This is an advanced building that we are talking about. The fire security, lighting, acoustics, okay, the basic facility that you did in your second year, okay, your parking, basements, ventilation, everything is going to be a part and parcel of it. Okay, so okay. First, we'll study about seating capacity, how the seating capacity we calculate for in an auditorium. So we have told you that up to 100, 150 ka, small kind of auditorium you have to make. So that's fine. Okay. But seating capacity actually depends on the format of the, so that means what the brief says. Okay. The sight lines, and we'll talk about what are the sight lines. Acoustics. Circulation and seating density, size and shape of the platform, as well as state. The last one is very important, size and shape of the platform. because according to my stage, I have to plan my seating. Otherwise, what is the point of seating in an auditorium and I don't see half of the stage? So actually, the seating capacity, or rather the shape of the auditorium, is derived from the shape of the stage. Okay, and we'll do the construction of how do you arrive at the shape of the auditorium. Aage jaake. Size, this is how you will derive the size. This is general thumb rules. Okay, you can go aage piche, depending how lavish you want. At least 0.5 meter square per person is to be used. Okay, per means per person. Is to be used seat width into the row spacing of at least of 0.45 meter square per seat. Now, if you do this in a diagram, guys, actually you should work this out. Don't go by what I am saying, okay? Aapko actually book lena hai, paper lena hai, take a pencil and actually work out what is the normal size of a seat, okay, that a person sits on in the auditorium. What should be the ideal aisle that should be so that a person who's sitting in the middle, and if he has to leave the auditorium for whatever emergency, okay, he has to be able to pass through a person who is sitting in a row. So that much space has to be left. And then you take the entire calculation, it will come to almost 0.5 meter square, okay? And to be on a little tighter side, they put 0.45, okay? But generally 0.5 to 0.6 is a very comfortable per person dimensions used in the auditorium. Unless it's a school wala where, you know, school is a little lavish because you know how the kids are and all that. So there they keep a little bit more, but in a proper commercial auditorium where they want to fit in maximum seats within that given area, 0.5 is the measures used. So this is how they have done. So you actually, can you see my cursor? If not, then I'll go by laser. So this is actually the seat that they mentioned. Okay, so this is around 0.4 and then this much is what? And then you say 0.4 by 0.4 and then this much is this. So basically you take this dimension and then figure out that this is going to be exactly 0.5. So plan and elevation, dono diya hai. Okay, right? Length of the rows. How long should be the rows? Because you are planning auditorium, right? People are going to sit one after the other in a continuous row. Kitna lamba hona chahiye so that it becomes comfortable psychologically, okay? People are very, so I mean, I am very skeptical. If I get an end seat, I'm a happy person, okay? But if I get right in the middle, it's not a happy situation for me. I mean, that's my perception about auditorium. Somebody can be different. Why is that so, okay? People are always aware that, they might have some emergency. In today's day and time, mobiles are there. So if somebody calls from home, I have to leave the order. It's very embarrassing to say, excuse me, and cross all those 15 people who are sitting right next to you, okay? So how long should an ideal row be? Maximum, it should have number. Ideal number is 14, okay? But sometimes you will see that people extend till 16. It's okay. I mean, if you want, you can keep 25. Who gives a hoot to that? But then it's uncomfortable for the people who are using it. There are no such things as, oh, you will not get NOC. The bylaws will stop you. Nothing like that. That is only for safety purpose and all that. Yes, because if that is not there, you will not get NOC or structural purpose. But these are something that are psychologically and sensitive design where you are taking care of the comfort level of the people, and this is what we do it, okay? Now, it also depends on the number of doors you have. If you have multiple doors planned, okay, for whatever reason, maybe you are thinking, this is a seismic zone. Suppose you are planning in Japan, and Japan is known for its seismic activity. So there, the auditoriums will probably have more number of exit doors than what we would probably have in Bombay, okay? Bombay, we don't fall into such heavy kind of seismic activity. But if you are planning there, you will definitely need to give more exit area. Now, if you have more exits, then people, as I say, can go to 25 seats per aisle is permissible if one side exit door of 1 meter width is provided per 3 to 4 rows. Teen char row ke baad ek darwaza aata hai. Teen char row ke baad ek darwaza aata hai. Agar ye possibility hai, then you can go for 25. But still, guys, if you ask me, I will not be comfortable sitting in the middle of that 25 and I am the 12th person either from either side. and then I have to disturb all 12 and go out, okay? But theek hai, I mean, these are some of the norms that are given and prescribed by the Newfords and the standards, so you need to go by. Volume of the room, okay? This is very important because yahan pe we are talking about acoustics. The sound has to travel and has to sound right. So how and what should be the volume as per the function of the auditorium? Now, as I showed you last time, Berlin Philharmonica, where it is completely for music and one of the finest of the auditorium where music operas are concerned, okay? So for opera, you have a multipurpose hall, you have you have speech where only the speech is given, like in a school auditorium, right? For every this thing, you will have different kind of volume suggested, okay? Basics of acoustic is requirement is reverberation, okay? And what is reverberation? We will do that. There is a formula to calculate reverberation time. What is the definition of reverberation time? We will do all that next lecture, but just keep this in mind. Basically, as the name suggests, it reverberates, okay? How long the sound stays in a place is known as reverberation, roughly speaking, is as follows. Playhouses, like you have dramas and you have some plays being conducted there, it should be 4 to 5 meters cubed per person. So if you have 100, the volume should be 100 into 4, 400 meter cube, okay? Where height, you can fix, say, around 6 meters. And so then you say 400 divided by 6 should be your area. Or you know the area by the seating capacity. The seating capacity is 0.5 hai and you have 100 people. So my area is roughly speaking 0.5 into 100 is around 50. Theek hai? Plus some 25% I will give to the aisle. Okay. And so that means there will be 50 into whatever 0.75, you will get that 0.25, you will get that total area. And then height depends. So based on this way, rough calculation can be arrived at very, very quickly. If a client asks you or if a contractor asks you, these are some of the thumb rules we use to quickly give them an idea. Ki, baba, itna roughly idea hoga, batao, kitna costing hoga, you know, so that kind of stuff we go by. Opera hai. What is the opera? It's, as I say, the sound, bolte na, goonjna chahiye. It has to reverberate there. It has to be there. That continuity of the sound has to be there. So opera is around 6 to 8 meter cube per person of the air volume, okay? Now for technical ventilation reasons, the volume should be no less than these figures so as to avoid air changes which are too pronounced, that means the draughts, okay? Now this we will do in the services where HVAC systems and everything will be there. But just mind it that just because you have space, you don't give me more, you know? Jitna bola hai, utna hi dijiye, because otherwise your HVAC will create problems. Imagine you have to throw 6 meters of length of the air draft, over the auditorium. If you do not have the possibility of putting it on your head. If not, then you will have to give me jet propellers and they make a lot of noise. Okay, so there are various systems of doing it. We are not going to go that into detail here. That will do it in the fourth year. But just understand, these are the background noises that will be there, which also acoustic has to cater to. So any questions here? Okay, is this part clear? These are the some of the basic requirement where you will start dealing with when you start taking, when you start planning your auditorium. Seating capacity, which you already have, 100 to 150. Auditorium size, how do you derive by this figure? Okay, length of the rows, kitna rakhna hai, that also now you know. That so if you are 12 or 14, keep lesser, okay, and volume of the room, you know. Theek hai? Yeah? Hi, this is yes. But why this is not going ahead? Okay, it went ahead. I think there is a lag again. Yeah. Okay. So this was exactly what I was saying. So if you are sitting like this, if this is the stage and some picture is being there, or maybe this is the background and backstage ka thing, See the eye level, okay? And I'm going to give the information about this. So this is how your seats should be planned, okay? I deliberately took this a little larger image so that people can see this properly. And the same thing here, because this is where people will make mistakes. The length of the row, the number of people in a row, where the aisle should be, what should be the size of the aisle. It should be comfortable enough for 2 to 3 people to walk together, okay? You have seen, na, aap movie theaters mein gaye ho. So you have seen that when during the break time, the interval is only of 10 minutes. And in that 10 minutes, your 100 of people, I would say not all will visit the loo, but at least 50, half of them will visit the loo, okay? From that 50, again, 50-50%. So maybe assuming that there are 50 ladies and 50 gents, okay? Of that 50 and a 25-25 will visit the loo. And so that's why your loo planning, your aisle planning is all very important in an auditorium, because we are planning for those 10 minutes of interval, okay? Baad mein, it doesn't matter, na? But in that important 10 minutes of interval, well, nobody wants to miss, and especially if it's a thriller or a murder movie, nobody wants to miss even a scene. So that's very important planning. So yeah, these are some of the things, and this distance I'll be telling you. But generally, so you can imagine, the steps is generally 150 mm, right? Okay. Now, if this guy is sitting here, whatever the height, human, that you will get obviously from the new first, okay, the next person ka row should be about 10 mm above the head of this guy, okay? Because that is the size of the eye to the head level. So that much is the, and that's how you will get the racking in place. So that's how you do 10 mm ka steps. If you see, the steps in the auditorium are not like your normal 150 mm. They are lesser. They are not like, and please do not plan 17 mm ka. Impossible. Nobody will climb those things, okay? Though it is extremely, it will be very nice. But it will be so steep now that at the end, the person will not be able to see the stage. So the racking is very important. Okay, now let's see. Can you see the next slide? I have already changed the slide. So I guess as usual, there is a lag in the internet. So the proportional proportion of traditional auditorium guy. It's happening. Okay. Right. So now... So this is what you will see in a textbook, okay, where you don't understand a thing. Ye kya hai? But this is exactly how you will derive your auditorium shape. Okay, so what is this? Can you see the red line that appeared? Now, A, do you see point? So that is the back wall of my theater. Theek hai? That is the back wall. A is my last row. Then you see BC. The BC, that is the end point of my stage. I mean, start point of my stage. So this entire thing, let me go pen. Okay, so this whole thing is now my seating area. This area, if you can see, this is my stage. The one done in green is my stage. And, oh, 1 second, I'll erase this. I'm back here again. And remember, I talked about the thrust. Thrust is this part, the one that is coming into the audience from the stage. This is an extended part of the stage. Now, that can be of a different shape. Some, as I told you and I showed you last time, that thing was like this. You know, the whole part was coming out like this. Depends what is the program of the entire auditorium. If it's a small one where people needs to interact, then it can be. So this can be also another kind of a thrust. Okay, but that's not the idea. Here we are planning of what exactly the, how do I get the shape of my auditorium correct, right? So B and C are the points where the curtains will drop from. Okay, so these are the holding points, and yahan pe jo red line hai, that will wear the curtain. What is the line of the curtain known as? Anybody? Last time we talked about it. Anybody? What is this line of curtain called as in technical jargon? Nobody? One class, somebody. Are likha hai udhar proscenium kya hai? Huh? Okay, so this is proscenium. Okay, now you see the green shaded part, that is my stage area. Okay, you see the P is a point, imaginary point here. P is the imaginary point that you will draw as an architect on the paper. It is not there on the site. Okay. So P is a point to determine the width of the auditorium at the back. How do I get this? Ye jo mera hai, how do I get this? And I get this, and that is because of this. From the P, I will draw. And so you see the line of B and P. And that's how I will draw this line. Okay, so ultimately, what did I say? The shape of the auditorium will be as per the shape of the stage. Okay, that's what I meant when I did this. I remove all this so that's easy. Okay, so you got it till now. This was the last row. Okay, A, where is it's a last row. Okay, B and C are the points on the stage, the start of the stage towards the from the auditorium side. Okay, audience side. The red line is the proscenium. The green is the stage. P is the imaginary point. P, when you connect to the B and C and you get these two dotted lines, that will give me the shape of the auditorium. Okay? And also, now the another point of consideration or another point to decide. And who decides? You decide. You are the architect. You are the space planner. And that is the shaded area. Now, this is the important part. What does the shaded area mean? It means that this part of the stage is not visible by this guy. See now, uska line of vision cut ho raha hai. He will never see this part of the stage. Similarly, when this guy is sitting here, he will not be able to see this part of the shaded area. So actually, if you want to reduce this, you will have to either shift P in, okay, or you have to shift it out. Kaise karoge aap? That you figure out, you do your geometry and you figure out the moment you push your P ahead or towards the stage, accordingly the size of the stage will change. And my point of concern is this shaded area. I don't want my shaded area has to be the least. That is called as a good planning, because if maximum area of the stage is shaded, then it's a problem. But is this clear? This is a really important. If you don't understand, I'll repeat everything again. But I want the class to say yes, no. And whoever did not understand, please say so. Be bindas.
Sorry, Mira, but what? Okay, multiple people.
So I just want to know how do we choose this imaginary point B? We can take it anywhere we like, or does it have to be at a specific
center? Good point. Good question. It's a geometry. See, na, the center hai. This is the center line. It has to be at the center. If I put P here, what will happen is I will get a very teda kind of a stage, you know. And you can actually take that. I'm not saying this. Suppose if I plan my audit, if this is the room, okay. Can you see the drawing that I'm doing on screen? Yeah. No, it is going to happen after some time. There is a time lag. Yeah. So do you see the square that I did? Now suppose you want to place your stage here for whatever reason. Okay. Maybe it's a small room and you're planning a small dais and you want that round kind of a feeling to happen. And you want this KK. So then you are planning your auditorium like this. Okay. Something like this. Okay. This is what you have planned. Then in this case, you can place P anywhere that you want. Maybe it is not in a centralized way. Then it is okay, because that's how you want your vision, and it depends on how your structure and everything is going to be. But in an ideal auditorium, when you have the center, okay, like you are actually planning it like a proper thing, in such a scenario, what you will do is you will take the central line. Makes sense, no? So this is the center. The line that I'm drawing here will be the center.
But we can take this P at any distance from the stage.
You to decide, dear. That's what I said. It's an imaginary. This P is responsible for this. This P is responsible for the blue shaded area that I have done on the plan. Right? So this is the central line on which your P will line. So A and P, okay. And then this P, ko agar humne piche liya. Suppose I put my P here. And now I draw the line. Now this is... And now if I draw, sorry for my lines, okay? If I connect P and B, obviously the shaded will be lesser. So as you go away from the stage, the shaded area will reduce. And that is actually the prime reason why you will decide where to take P. I did not tell you that. There are no fixed this thing. It also depends on what is the size of this, okay? So if I go and see a stage in Bhaidas Hall, and if versus I see a stage in NCPA, they are so different. The complete, I mean, Bhaidas is tiny compared to what I have in NCPA. NCPA is like huge. Okay, so that's why there, if you see, there are no shaded parts. It's a complete round thing. But in Bhaidas, yes. If you are sitting in a Bhaidas Hall, and if you are sitting on the right-hand side of the Bhaidas Hall, you cannot see little part of the, I am not saying most of them, you can say little part of the stage is not seen from where you are sitting there, because it's been planned like that. So the wings are then put there. So if suppose you have a, let me draw it out for you so that you get an idea. Suppose you have this kind, suppose maybe there are site constraints and you can't go beyond this, chalo. If something like that happens, tab aap kya karoge? Best, what you can do is this. You can do this. I will put my wings like this. Wings thoda dekhna hai mujhe. Do you see my drawing? No, it's still loading. Yeah, can you see the wings now?
Yeah.
So now it's clear. Now I see every part of the auditorium. But essentially that means that now my stage is trapezoidal. Okay. It's a trapezoid. It's not a square that you imagine. So if suppose you have performance like Shamak Davar, who gets his troupe of 40 people on stage, then this will not be sufficient. Because peeche people khade nahi reh paayenge, you know, they will dash into each other. So then you will have to plan your stage accordingly. That's why I say P is the point of imagination. Depending on the use, depending on the function that are going to be planned in the auditorium, it is in your hand whether you want broad stage, whether you want small stage, whether you want a more hidden stage or a trapezoidal or a square. Completely aapke haath mein. It's all about arriving at a geometry by shifting this P. P to fixed hai, hai na? Also, you can change this. So if you say, I want to keep P here, P ko yahin pe rakhna. Maybe you can shift stage ka thoda sa distance yahan pe. You can say, I'm making the bigger stage here. But P same hai. But now my distance will be this. So my end, this will increase. You understand now what I'm saying? Now I'm joining this. Of course, lag hai. Now this is the point. So now my backside or the backside of the auditorium has increased. Can you see what I've done? So it is all up to you. Ye geometry aapko decide karna hai. And who decides the geometry? The function decides the geometry. Then what is the kind of stage you require? And accordingly, you will work out. So that's why I'm going to tell you what is the stage ka proportion. How do you arrive at the stage proportion and how is then that versus the volume of the auditorium? But are we clear on the construction of the basic construction idea of the stage versus auditorium?
Meenal, can you just... sorry, go ahead.
No, you can go ahead.
Sorry?
Okay.
Can you just repeat the significance of the 30 degree angle that is written? Sure.
30 degree is not really that important. Okay. Some people want to go by that. Actually, it is ideal. But so 30 degree gives me this problem. Okay. 30 degree makes this distance fixed. Because this means that from A, if I join line to B, join line to C, then it gives me 30 degree. But that is a limitation. Unless you have a small auditorium planned, that's why I did not mention 30 degree. If you are planning, so tumhare mein possible, it's only 100 people. But if you are planning a really like ओपेरा हाउस वो 30 डिग्री मायने नहीं रखता है बिकॉज इट्स वे बियॉन्ड दैट. आई मीन यू विल नेवर बी एबल टू अचीव इट बिकॉज दिस इज गोइंग टू बी रियली फार.
That becomes more like a semicircle in its opening, right? Those large opera.
अभी वो semicircle रखना है. You want to keep it straight. Again, that is your geometry. How you want to plan your auditorium. That's what I'm saying, guys. These are some of the ideas that I'm showing. These are the fundamental principles on which the auditorium is based on. But how do you then implement it is completely your take and your call. That's exactly what Ainsley was explaining last technology lecture, na? That he was very firm on the idea ki mujhe ye A-shaped column chahiye, that A thing he wanted. And he went after that, okay? He sat, he debated, he talked with that guy, structural engineer, and he went for it, okay? Because he was fixed with that idea and he somehow understood that it could be done, okay? After sitting with the structural engineer. So that means that Ainsley had enough structural knowledge to understand that this kind of loads are possible. That's why we teach you structures. But that does not give Mr. Ainsley Lewis the right to design structures for his building. That would be a failure. He would definitely need a very competent structural engineer to help him out with all these kind of stuff. So largely, the job of an architect is not only to envision the building, but to take a stand for that building. Okay, yes, I want my building to be like this. But that stand should not be very rigid. It has to be a little flexible because you also have to commemorate that there are other consultants who come with their power of competency. And when they come into the picture and they tell you, boss, if you do this, then there are going to be massive issues. But then you can sit and argue with him unnecessarily, or you try to sit with him and say, what if we do this? Is it possible? What? फिर तुम ऐसा बोलोगे कि नहीं ये तो हो ही नहीं सकता है because Ainsley did it, I will also do it. ऐसे नहीं होता है. There has to be this two-way discussion where he will tell you something and you have to understand that why is he saying that. That understanding of subject, that understanding of problem has to be there. And then it can happen. Okay, so that's exactly what I'm saying. These are the principles that I'm telling. P किधर रखना है, A किधर रखना है, 30 degree क्या है, BC का. Now this BC can go bigger, na? Because I'm saying this is only going to be, or if Shyamak Davar imagines that I am hosting this kind of show very often, and I want an auditorium for myself and my group to perform, okay? And in his own training institute, he will have one small auditorium there. Now that auditorium will be small, but the stage will be very big, you know, because he wants big stage for his troupe to function there. So again, the planning will be very different from what your Bhaidas Hall or Prithvi is there. But essentially, this will be the principles. Positioning of P, positioning of A, BC, stage, shaded area are some of the concerns. And you will have to play with this. Ye ek khilona karke aapko khelna hai to get the shape. Phir isko aapko round rakhna hai, or you want to make this staggered kind of a thing, or you want to make it parabolic. It's completely your take. Did I make myself clear? And I will repeat for those people who want to get this thing done, okay? Let's do this then. Okay, so we go to the bear and we start from there, okay? So A is a point of the last point, okay? But let's not go by the A, okay? But anyway, this was the start point which I took. So this is the last row in the auditorium, okay? And why did I do the curve, or why did this guy, whoever did this diagram originally, did unhone curve kyun liya? Because remember, we talked about a curved seating is very, very cozy kind of a seating, okay? So psychologically, people feel connected. They might not be connected, okay? People from all arena come to auditorium and they don't know each other. But still that brotherhood kind of feeling comes when it's a kind of a curved thing. That is the only thing, okay? It can be straight. It could be something like this. I mean, I can have my auditorium planned like this, where I have my seating like this, I have my seating like this, and I have my seating like this. Okay? Kaise bhi kar sakte hain. But, so this was the basic, this thing. Theek hai? So the first line of drawing is my A. This is the last thing. if I take the center point of A and I draw a central line, okay, I'm drawing a central line. At the other side of the A is the P, is an imaginary point, okay? Where we put the P is something we'll talk later. But if I have to say that I want to decide, and I know that there are 100 people, I've already designed the aisle and I've already designed this is what I want. And I say that between the two aisles, the distance is going to be around 1 meter. And so this is how my aisles are going to be. So itna distance mujhe chahiye. So you have figured out that this is the distance you want. Then you say that is this 30 degree? So you do this. That ye mujhe 30 degree milta hai ki nahi. So this is my 30 degree. So you get B and C. So this is the first part of the stage. Now, once you get the stage, now you want the stage to be like this. The shape of the stage bhi aap control kar sakte ho. Okay, you say, main stage hi trapezoidal banata hun. So forget about, there will be no problem only. So you design trapezoidal stage. That is also fine. It is all up to you. That's what I'm saying. Okay, but anyway, going by this diagram, if B and C are the 2 points now I got because I connected this 30 degrees, okay, I got this first line. From there, I will draw the stage. Now, depth of the stage again, kiske dependent hai? Aapke program pe dependent hai. How can I say or Swati say? Okay. So it's up to you whether you want 10 feet, whether you want 20 feet, is up to you. Okay? So whatever. So you decided this depth. And then you say that this, if this is the depth, and if I put my P so that I get this point in space, so that I know that this will be the shape of my auditorium. Hai na? So then you decide the P and then you draw. If you take P somewhere here, obviously the length will be more, okay, of this because broader hai. Also, it will cut down my shaded portion, which is always good. So I don't want shaded portion. It's a bad idea to have most of the part or even a little part of the stage to be not seen by the spectator. Ideally, a good stage should be seen by all from... I mean, the whole of the stage should be seen by all of the audience. That is the ideal situation. Okay, so you plan your stage accordingly. And I gave you. So the options are here. The options are here. The options are the shape. The option is P. Bahut sare options hai. So you play with your geometry. Okay. Am I clear? Did I clear your doubts?
Meenal, I wanted yes. to ask. Is there a way to decide the distance between the stage and the first roof?
Sorry, can you repeat? Your voice was gone.
Sorry, is there a way to decide the distance between the stage and the first roof?
Yes, there is. There is, and I'll come to that. Yes, actually, it's a good point, okay? So what happens? So do you think, very important point, actually. Thank you for coming, asking that. So what should be the distance between the stage and the first row? Okay. Then you have, say, around 7 rows hota hai, people are sitting one after the other. And then another aisle, horizontal aisle happens. So if I show here, if I show in this plan, okay, the first row is here. Okay. And I'm not doing 3D here. It's the one line is, imagine this is a complete seating. Okay. And similarly, 7 rows are happening and the second aisle is this. So aisle is where people walk. Okay? Now, this length, this depth or width rather, and this width, should they be same? Ideally, no, na? Ye toh sirf chalne ke liye kaam aata hai. But stage ke aage bahut kuch dhating ho sakta hai na? Sometimes the whole of the performers can come down. Especially in a school ceremony. You guys have not seen the coronation that happens in our college. But unfortunately, for the past 2 years, we had to do online and not a very happy situation. But when the entire thing happens and then in the end, people tend to just stand there in front of the first row and people congratulate them. So a lot of things or rather interaction with the audience happen. So this distance is generally, okay, 2.5 meters, okay, ideally. And if you imagine that this is a proper school, ekdam fun masti wala auditorium hone wala hai in future, it can be even 3 meters. Theek hai? So otherwise, generally, all the aisles are planned as 1.5 or 2 meters. Am I clear?
We also have to worry about like how the person in the first row will look at the stage, right? The stage is too high.
That's where the racking... Yes, yes. Yeah. That's where the stage ka height is important versus the seating ka height. So it's up to you whether you want to keep racking right from the first person or you want to give certain flat rows and then you take the racking. But it depends on your stage height that you have designed. That's why sight lines are very important, and we'll discuss that in the sight lines. Everything in auditorium is related to one thing. So I'm very happy to know that you guys are jumping ahead to know all this. But yes, sight lines will decide whether the first guy is going to sit his chair right on the floor or there will be a racking. Agar aapne stage high plan kiya, you have planned for 1 meter because you wanted niche ka space, because you are planning some part of the stage to be raised up. And you realize ki are baba mere paas niche to jagah nahi hai aur mujhe basement mein bahut deep karna nahi hai, mere paas paisa nahi hai, whatever reason you say that, and you say that okay, I only have limited space, so in that case you will have to lift the stage up. Now if you lift the stage up and the first guy is not sitting on a racking, uski to neck ka problem hai, because he will have to constantly sit like an ostrich, you know, and to ekdam aisa, you know, to, I don't know what to say, but usko jhukna padega aage to see whether what is happening on the stage, or he will only see the feet of the people, or he'll have to tilt his head up or something like that. Not a very comfortable situation. So good question. Yeah, so are we clear on this? So can I go on the next this thing?
Meenal,
so
I had a question.
Bolo.
Yeah, so like based on the imaginary point, like the shaded area changes. So like if we are trying to reduce the shaded area, does it affect the size of the wings, or do we like later offset the stage for the wings which are not to be visible?
Good. Okay. Now, who decides this area? Iska form kaun decide karega? Aap decide karoge na? You are the architect. ये मुझे बंद करना है, बट दिस इज नॉट, देर इज नो रिस्ट्रिक्शन इन हाउ मच आई प्लान ऑल दिस एरिया. तो कितना विंग, आई कैन हैव माय विंग्स लाइक दिस आल्सो, बिग वन, सॉरी दिस इज द रॉन्ग पोजीशनिंग ऑफ द विंग्स, विंग शुड ऑलवेज बी लाइक लूअर्स, व्हाट इज इट, दिस शुड नॉट शो मी द द द द द ऑडियंस शुड नॉट सी, सो विंग्स आर ऑलवेज प्लेस्ड लाइक दिस. नाउ इफ द विंग्स कैन बी इनसाइड, ओके, एंड एज आई सेड, व्हाई डोंट यू प्लान योर ऑडिटोरियम, आई मीन योर स्टेज ओनली लाइक दिस, with my wings planned like this, but then there is no shaded area. Is there a restriction ki stage circle hi hona chahiye, stage square hi hona chahiye, stage rectangle hi hona chahiye? No. Oh, you can have octagonal shape if you want. I mean, you design, the shape is up to you.
I have a question. So earlier, I think we mentioned that the distance, like the height difference between two rows, is like 150. But can it go up to like 450?
No. I didn't say 150. I said the riser will be 100, not 150. 150 is not enough. 150 mein aadmi kaise pass hoega?
No. I meant the height difference between two consecutive rows.
Yeah. That is around 10 mm.
But it can't go to like 450 mm.
No. How will it be? Okay. I'll show you in the racking. So I'll show you here only. In this plan only, I can show you what will happen if there is... Okay. So you go 150 like this. 10 mm is like this. Okay. Then a chair sits here. Okay. The chair is here. And you need to keep some space for the person to go by. Okay, so this is a chair. Plus, then what happens is right where the chair ends, you will rise your step. Okay, then another chair sits here. And a person ko jaane ki jagah chahiye. Okay, similarly, this will also have this and it will go up. Okay, similarly, it will go up and go down. Now, this distance is that 0.5 that I mentioned, that is square meter. This is the distance, will not be square meter, it will be just meter. So you need to figure out what is the chair ka size, what is the size of the chair is one thing that you need to figure out, depends how lavish you want, plus the person ka walking need. So this is your length that you are talking about, and then this will be the depth you are talking about, and that is why you get 0. Am I clear what I'm saying? So this is how you will get, barabar. So I get this as an angle of racking. Versus if I do this. Versus I do this. Okay, one, two, three, and then a chair comes. One, two, and then a chair comes. Okay, maybe I'll do it here. Chair, one, two, three. Now do you see the steepness of it? Right? So a person is sitting here. You'll have to climb down, and then this guy is sitting here. But by the time the stage goes up, where will they, will you be able to see the stage?
Okay.
Yeah. So that angle, to maintain that angle is very important. That is all we are striving for. Okay.
I had a doubt.
Follow.
So you said that if the shaded area is not there, that means the angle is changed, as in the wings are arranged in a specific way, so such that the shaded area is not there. So the number of seats or the number of rows will also vary, right, according to the angle, because like the shaded area reduces.
Yes. But there are people, and there are auditoriums where people don't see the stage. They really do that. Okay. And it's not one of the favorite seats of the people, and they even charge you less for those. Because people have complained. And then the people, once word of mouth happens, people know that this auditorium has these problems.
So
that's what I'm saying. That's why I am saying, guys, there are so many determining points here. So this is a factor of determination. This is a factor of determination. This is a factor of determination. This is a factor of determination of how distance you want. 30 ka angle is a determination. How exactly you want your rows. That's why I'm saying this is all a play of geometry. Maybe you will do. So there are lots of this. What do you call them? You'll have to give lots of layouts for this, where you say, I'm going to play with P, or somebody say, no, I'm going to play with BC, or somebody say, no, I'm going to extend A out. And then what happens to this? But in a way, all of them are related. They're tied down. You see, there is a proper kite kind of a formation formed here, where 30 degree is holding BC and BC is also held by P. But by giving proper P position, I get shaded area or not shaded area, depends how you plan it. And by giving 30 degree, it gives me the number of rows. So you plan your rows by taking away A further, and you plan your shaded area by taking P further. Or if you want to P here, because it's sufficient hai tumhare liye. But yet you don't want this, then as I told you, change the shape of the stage. And side stage is in your hand. You want it small, you want it big. It's a completely your take. Am I clear? Yes, yeah, somebody had a question.
Yeah.
Somebody had a question? Are we clear on this? I think when you start doing your auditoriums, now you will understand what exactly. Because as I say, it's not there. That's why I have not given any distances, guys. Nahi to main bolti na, 2.5 meter kaise maine bol diya. That is fixed. That I need it. But am I giving you any distance? No, because it is all a play thing. You have to play with it to get the correct shape and size that you have planned on your site. And all of you are having individual sites. So how can I give you size and shape for this? No way. But I am giving you principles, geometrical. Jaise aapne, you understood those theorems of geometry you did in the 10th. Na? They give you the idea about doing isosceles triangle. Now that isosceles triangle can encompass the earth, or it can encompass your table. I mean, it's up to you how you plan your isosceles triangle. How big that triangle is. Aisa. Okay, moving ahead. Now this will not go ahead. Okay, so these are the maximum distances. Okay, playhouse 24 meter. Now these are the some of the distance which are constraining as far as if I want to see the expression on the face of the people, if I want to hear proper this thing. Okay, so in a playhouse, what is important? आप ड्रामा देखने आए हो एंड यू डोंट अंडरस्टैंड हाउ दैट गाय इज एक्टिंग देन इट्स पॉइंटलेस ना. सो 24 मीटर इज द लेंथ. सो ए शुड बी एट 24 मीटर्स फ्रॉम दिस. नाउ दीज आर सम ऑफ द सेड थिंग्स. ओके सम पीपल फॉलो सम पीपल डोंट फॉलो इफ इट इज अ कमर्शियल. Nowadays, what they do, pata hai na? They put huge screens on the sidewall. So if you see, I'll draw it out for you so that you understand where they put the TV. So the stage kaisa hota hai na? Abhi yahan pe aapki wings hai. You have put the wings here. You have given me trapezoidal, taki you are not able to. Say that mera koi bhi side of the stage is not cut. So people are seeing everything on the stage because yahan pe to wings hai, and I don't want people to see the wings any which way. तो मैंने ट्रेपेजॉइडल शेप ही बनाया. ओके द शेप ऑफ माय स्टेज इज फिक्स्ड एंड नाउ आई हैव रिमूव्ड द शेडेड पोर्शन. फाइन चलो. नाउ यू से दैट व्हाट वाज द पॉइंट दैट आई वाज डिस्कसिंग. आई गॉट लॉस्ट इन दिस. हां द टीवी. सो व्हाट दे डू इज नाउ व्हाट यू दिस इज वेयर योर साइड स्टेज इज गोइंग टू हैपन राइट. दिस इज योर साइड स्टेज है ना. यहाँ पे आपके स्टेप्स रहेंगे. पीपल विल गो अप. देर इज आइल हियर. देर इज एन आइल हियर एंड इन बिटवीन और मे बी देर इज अ सेंट्रल आइल. आई डोंट नो हाउ यू हैव प्लान्ड. ओके दिस इज हाउ द रोज आर हैपनिंग ब्ला 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 व्हाटएवर. नाउ इफ अ पर्सन इज सिटिंग हियर द वॉल मे बी एक्सटेंडेड समथिंग टिल हियर एंड आई विल पुट माई टीवी हियर. ओके आई विल पुट माई टीवी हियर एंड दे आर लार्ज टीवी. So that people, and if this is beyond 24 meters, and say this person is sitting at 30 meters, okay, he can still get a clear picture from the large TVs that are placed on either side. So even if the stage mein mujhe, I mean, I am more interested in seeing the play acting, but still. That can happen. Hmm? Am I clear? Okay, and for opera, it is 32 meters. Important movements still recognizable, but movements are not so important in opera. The person singing, I should be able to get a good sound of it. So, can be more. Can be more. Yeah? Clear? Right, now coming to the stage proportion. Now, the stage proportions are equally important because they have to be pleasing, okay? And the scale and proper proportion is so important because stage ko hi hum dekhte hai na, when we come for the performance seeing, we see only the stage. So, stage proportions are this. So, your proscenium, apron height, volume of the auditorium are determined, okay? So, this is what your start of this point is what will determine your what your stage. And if you can see here, forming a golden rectangle of 1.6 is to 1. Yani ki, if your length of the if your height of the stage is 1 meter, okay, let's go by this. If the length of your the height of your stage is 1 meter, okay, your width of the stage will be 1.6. Or the length, jo bhi hai, width will be this. So the length will be 1.6. So if the height is 10, this will be 16. Is this clear?
Yes.
Is this clear? This is how your line of proscenium, yani upar se, where will you stop the stage being seen? So the opening into the stage, okay, the proscenium, what we call it as the eye to the stage is 1.6 is to 1. Okay, this is the golden ratio that we all know, and I hope you know. If not, then please read Corbusier's Modular. That book is available in our library. It is, I think, now available online as well. I think you should all read that. It's really nice book. It kind of gives you the way modularity work in the world, and this is the golden ratio. And if you see the just go and read the book. It's really nice. I'll not go into the theory of that, but yeah, right. So this is how your stage will be done. So your lines of vision and everything will be based on this proportion that we are talking about. Okay, now let's talk about the racking. Racking cheese kya hai? Racking is nothing but taking your auditorium in a way that everybody can see the thing on the stage and everybody gets the beautiful acoustics, okay? Now look at the first thing. What is happening here is, now when the rake is flat, you can see this is a flat. I'll take my pen. Okay, so this is a flat. No angle, no raising, nothing. People are sitting on the ground. I mean, not on the ground, on a chair which is kept on the ground, okay? But it's like they are on a same level as the ground, okay? Now see what happens, okay? It's using the Pythagoras theorem. Okay, this is the principle of getting the raking, and we'll see what. Now look at the sound that has to travel. Okay, the sound always travel in circle. We know that, right? That's why when a person bhale na wo samne ki taraf dekh ke bolta hai, but people who are standing behind can also hear him. Na, aisa to nahi hai ki light kaise it goes in single line. Okay, so if the light is for if the torch is in the front direction, okay, you don't get light at the back somehow. Unless it's so powerful that it goes into that. So you have umbra and penumbra and all that. Not so in a sound. If I'm speaking, people standing behind me for quite some distance, they are able to hear me because sound travels in a circle. We all know that. But I'm repeating this because sometimes I get questions, ki, then what does happen at that level? So that's why I'm clarifying this. Okay. So this is my what happens when the distance is large, okay, sound will also have to travel a long distance and much longer to reach, okay, because it is this. Imagine if I do this, distance kam ho jata hai na? When I do this, okay, this is the shortest distance. So now this will have to travel shortest. So that is the way I will try to shorten the distance the sound has to travel. We all know that when I am speaking in a class, and if the class is having 80 ka strength, the person, and you, I'm sure, have seen this. Some people have loud voice, okay? Like, I love what Sonal and Rohan have. Wow, what voluble voice they have. Huh? Versus me, I don't have a very strong voice, okay? And even if I try to speak loudly, but after some point of time, I get very tired. I don't have that strength, okay? Now that is my problem. Now suppose imagine you have 80-100 people sitting in a room and I'm trying to speak to them without mic or any amplifier. The distance will matter, because as the distance increases from me, the person sitting at the last row will hear little less intensity of my voice, okay? So the distinctness of speech which he is supposed to get will be reduced, because probably the intensity of sound that is supposed to reach him or her is not there. Okay. So what should I do? I should raise him up so that my sound will travel little less distance and he will get little more intensity. So that is the idea of doing the racking. Okay. So now to reduce the sound travel path, raise the auditorium. Apply Pythagoras theorem here. Okay, so that's exactly just what I say. Okay, now this is exactly what you were saying. Somebody asked me that 450 wala. If I'm not wrong, that was Fleur. Okay, so this was this shouldn't be so steep, right? They will topple onto each other. This is what happened. And if you go to see anybody visited kya naam hai? Bhakti Park wala, that round auditorium. I forgot the name of it.
The IMAX.
IMAX.
IMAX. Everybody seen? Have you been to that round auditorium?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, the dome kind of one, right?
Yeah, the dome one, okay, where they see 3D and all that, okay. There, it does have very steep raking on the top. And it's very irritating because when you eat something, and this has happened when I'd gone with my son there, okay? So, bought him a tub of popcorn, and kids being kids, he dropped few and it went into some lady's, you know, lap. So, you understand that it was really problematic when you have such steep racking, you know? So, yeah, this is what happened. That's why racking angle and racking methodology is very, very important. And in a closed auditorium, so this works far better. If there is no racking, problem, okay? Because sound gets reflected and this and that. And so it is better to have racking in a closed atmosphere, okay? Fine, so understood what is racking and how to do it. Now we'll go over that. Okay, can you see the change of size? But you guys have not seen the last one also. Yeah, I've changed the slide. And this is how now we are going to study how we do the racking, step by step. So I'll have to go slow because then only you will be able to. Okay, so imagine this is the first guy sitting here, okay? Imagine this is the stage. ठीक है? Understood? Can you see the stage which I draw? नहीं, which I drew, sorry. Yeah, this is the first guy sitting here. Okay, right? So first fix A. Okay, A is the eye position of the person in the first and the bottom most row. Ab idhar hai na, people ask me some question which main pehle hi aapko bata rahi hu. What if a 6'2" guy sit in the first row? Will you take his eye position? Or will you take the normal person's eye position? We go by Indian standard. If you are in China, go by China standard. If you are in Sweden where you have those hunks, okay, you go by those standards. Please, guys, follow the majority here, okay? Majority of the people would be 5'11", 5'10", and 5'6". So you take the average and fix A. So do not ask me these questions, okay? It's very common question which is being asked. But understand, we are talking about larger public, not just 1 6'2" wala. Amitabh Bachchan udhar aake baitha, well, he will have to suffer. Theek hai? But anyway, he is the first guy, so usko koi suffering ka problem nahi hai. Suffer karne wala, dusre bench wala hai, because he will see that tall guy sitting in front of him and will have a problem. But that's his issue for that particular time. So you fix A, that is the position of the eye of a normal person, okay, I'm using the word normal person, in the first and the bottom. Imagine, so there is a cut line here. Imagine karo ye cut line hai, theek hai? And this is the last row. Got it? So you imagine the last row, that is the thing here. Theek hai? That is the first step. Second. Then L is fixed with O as the eye position of person as the last and the topmost row of body. What does that mean? O. ठीक है, एक्चुअली रॉन्ग है, एक्चुअली ये बॉटम नहीं होना चाहिए, सॉरी, दिस इज रॉन्ग, सॉरी, ऑफ कोर्स इट्स राइट, सॉरी, व्हाट एम आई डूइंग, इट इज द बॉटम मोस्ट, नॉट द लास्ट, सॉरी, इट्स करेक्ट, सॉरी, या सो द बॉटम वन, दिस इज द मोस्ट बॉटम वाला ना, एंड द फर्स्ट इज द बॉटम पार्ट, राइट राइट ओके. Then L is fixed with O as the eye. So, jo ye aadmi baitha hai, which is on the last row, okay, and the topmost row, uska aap eye position fix karo. Let's name it L. Theek hai? You join the line. You join the line of the two eye position, okay? Eye position of that guy sitting at the first row and the last row. Till now, things are clear. Did you understand how do I get this line?
Could you repeat? I'm sorry. Could you just
repeat? Yeah. What I did, मैंने ऑडिटोरियम का डिजाइन बनाया, ठीक है? I made a auditorium design, and there are these number of rows that are happening. यहाँ पे to just to show you because I didn't want to have a very large diagram. Okay, I took a small diagram. ठीक है? Now, fix the position O. O is the position of the eye. तुम्हारा eye जहाँ पे है ना, that is consider that point as O. ये ओ इज अ पोजिशन ऑफ द फर्स्ट पर्सन सिटिंग ऑन द फर्स्ट रो. फर्स्ट रो इज द बॉटम पार्ट ऑफ द रो, है ना, सबसे नीचे रहता है वो. एंड देन यू टेक द ओ, अगेन दूसरा ओ लूंगी तो कंफ्यूज होगा, इसके लिए नाम उसको एल दिया है. ओके, सो यू डिसाइड द पॉइंट एल, ओके, ऑफ द गाय हु इज सिटिंग एट द टॉप मोस्ट रो विच इज द लास्ट रो. ठीक है, और वो दो पॉइंट को आप ज्वाइन कीजिए. आप ड्रॉइंग कर रहे हो, हेलो, आप ये रियलिटी में मत कीजिएगा. ओके, यू आर ड्रॉइंग राइट नाउ टू डिसाइड कि इसका रैकिंग कैसे होगा. राइट, सो यू डिसाइड दिस. अभी तक आपने रफ प्लानिंग किया है, ठीक है? राइट, टू चेक द साइट लाइन इज प्रॉपर फॉर द ओ, ड्रॉ पॉइंट एक्स सच दैट ए एक्स इज इक्वल टू एल बाई टेन. अभी ये सब क्या है, वॉट इज ए, ओके, ए एक्स is nothing but L upon 10. What is L? Do you see this distance? Okay. So somebody, Fleur, you said na 450 wala, and then I said no, there is one. So you decide ki ye maine 10 ka liya hai, okay? Ye, you are right now learning, so you will have to do this. Somebody says 11 centimeter, koi bolta hai 10 centimeter, koi bolta hai 15 centimeter. Up to you. And nowhere there are fixed norms. Guys, let me tell you, you will see some auditoriums having racking of 10 centimeter, 10, 100 mm ka step hota hai. Somewhere you will see 110 mm ka steps hota hai. Somewhere you will see there are 120. So it's up to you. But anyway, whatever it is. So aapne ye 100 mm ka diya hai. Theek hai? Let's go by 100 mm ka steps. So you, by doing this, okay, then you put a chair here, normal thing, and you make a normal human being ka caricature and decide this is my O. Theek hai? Similarly, you decided O here. Now you join this line, and that line ka jo parallel line hota hai, that is actually the line. Now, humko kya janna hai? What is this diagram for? Ki mere baad, if I am sitting here, this person who is sitting behind me is able to see ye 10 jo 100 mm hai wo sahi hai ki galat hai. That is the aim of doing this diagram. Whether the sight line of the people who are sitting one after the other are able to see clearly. You will notice this many times that we are not comfortable, especially if the tall people come. But forget about tall people. Even if a normal person sits in front of me, the racking is done so badly that the head of the person comes in front of me aur mujhe thoda teda hona hi padta hai. Okay, to get it. And then after 3 hours, I have backache, neckache, okay, and all that kind of stuff. So that means my sight line and the racking is very important. That's why I'm saying, guys, you will have to figure this out for your auditorium. 100, maine example liya. It can be 110. So 100 to 150, it's easy to climb, okay? Very easy to climb, hai na? You cannot climb 17 mm somehow, okay? It's very difficult. Try karo. 20 mm, bapre. Okay, you will see 20 mm where, you know, in the forts, where they have to climb those huge hillocks, okay? And they have minimum area. They will give 20 there, okay? Aur wahan pe ghode bhi chalte hain. Even their horses ride up. So that's why you have 20, but it's not fit for humans. 17, no. 15, okay. So you figure out. So this is how you will get the sight lines in place. Okay, so ye ho gaya, itna samjha?
What is
Did you understand this much?
PS.
Huh?
Oh, is P like the base of the stage or the eye level of the person who is on the stage?
Ah, good question. Tumhe kya lagta hai?
It's too high to be the base of the stage, but I don't know.
If this guy is here, tumhara stage kidhar hoga? Where will be the stage? If I do this, and if this is the height, okay, if this is 150, okay, my stage will be 1, hai na? Around 1 to idhar tak hoga. So this is the base of the stage that I'm doing. He is supposed to see the base. Imagine the base is topper than his height. Kya dekhega wo? So this guy should see the base of the auditorium. Sorry, dais of the stage. Okay, so that's the base.
Okay.
Okay. Right. So what I was saying. Yeah. So this is the base of this thing. Right. So you decided this. Now what you do is see the formula. AX. AX is this. Person ka aank. This is the eye of the person level and the point you decided X. Okay. How will you decide this X point? By L upon 10. Because you have the racking in place. Na? Aapne experiment kiya hai. You have decided that there are 7 rows. So you did all that and you did that 0.5 meter square per person ka chairs and the length of the aisle that is required in front of the chair. All that you did and you arrived at this L. किसी को 7 रोज है, किसी को 6 है, किसी को 5 है. Depends on the number of rows, L will figure out. It will be different. ठीक है? Now take this L, divide this by 10. Okay, that will be this distance. Suppose L is 15 meters. Divide that by 10. कितना होगा? 1.5. ठीक है? So that will be 15 mm. But I'll give you a thumb rule. You don't want to go by this simple thumb rule. Bahut simple hai. And people generally go by this, okay? Especially in auditoriums, when architects come, of course, there are consultants for that who will come and do the acoustics, and they will also advise you on some of the sight lines and vision lines, okay? But generally, as a planner, as a larger coordinator of the project, okay, if this is the person sitting here, okay, the next person ka distance should be around 10 to 15 mm. If you do this, it's good. So even if you go by this, it's fine. Okay? Are we clear? This is the basic thumb rule. If you have any questions, please ask now. Before I go ahead.
What is this maximum slope with steps 35 degree GLC written right just above L?
Okay. Maximum slope you can have is this. Beyond that, as I say, people will start toppling. Even that is not good. That's why racking ka koi slope dete nahi hai. You have to arrive at the slope of the racking. That's why I'm saying, guys, this is all geometry. How can I say 35? What they are saying is don't go beyond 35. That is problem. So they are giving you the limits. Beyond this, problem. Don't go beyond that.
Okay, thank you.
That is the thing. So it's a limit. Okay, and then there is one more box. Okay, the line of tier will be parallel to AO. So this is now A and this is O. Okay, you join and this line is parallel. But below AO. Now what is 1120? That is the height of the chair. Okay. Backside of the chair. So this is how you will basically configure the racking. Now, if this is actually agar parallel aata hai, suppose, okay, then more or less your racking is fine. More or less your racking will be fine. That is the idea and derivation of how the racking is done. Okay. Any questions?
Yeah. Can you please repeat the ideal distances of poles?
Ideal distances of?
I think the L you were talking about, the rise in the row.
L will depend, darling. It will depend on, suppose, tere auditorium mein, you have only 5 rows. Because you have done it very round kind of a thing. So everybody is more or less near the stage and distance from the stage is less. Well, I have planned as a shape, as a fan. And so my distance are far away from the stage and going in a fan shape, which I showed you in the earlier plan. Okay. Obviously, the L for me will be larger than L for you, okay? But if it is larger, that means every L by 10, I will require that, na? But for you, you won't require. So, tere liye L will be lesser because L chota hai.
Okay, yeah.
Got it?
Yeah, thank you.
Basically, the longer the auditorium, the steeper the racking, right?
You bet, obviously. Then only I'll be able, the last person will be able to see clearly, na? I know. Is that clear? This idea of racking is clear? Anyone has any doubt?
Can you repeat one point which you said just before the fourth point appeared, where the most people follow the thumb rule? So can you repeat that thumb rule?
The thumb rule is, if I am sitting, okay, main first bencher hoon, and I am sitting here, and you are the second bencher. Remember, your eye level should be 10 mm above my eye level. If you follow this, you won't go wrong. Or 150, chalo, that is still better. 15 mm mein sometime what happens is, humko lagta hai na, 15 mm, 5 mm mein kya hone wala hai? But guys, there are aisa, tu 7-8 rows lega na, racking thoda steep ho jata hai. So yes, it matters. So 10 mm to 15 mm, beech mein. So the distance between the two eye of the person should be 15 mm. If you do this as a planning, you will be fine.
I'm sorry, you just said 150 mm and then you said 10 mm. What is it exactly?
Oh, sorry. It's 10 mm, not 150. Sorry, change. Bahut ho jata hai. My God, racking to ekdam upar chala jayega.
So the distance is just 10 mm between the two eye levels.
Right. So if you want, you can actually put 4 fingers, okay, on your forehead and you will see it's around that much.
Okay, thank you.
So the riser is 10 mm for these, right?
Precisely. So then if you say, ki, no, 10 mm thoda kam hai, okay? Maybe there are tall people coming here. You can go for 12 mm or you can go for 15 mm. Doesn't matter. 15 mm riser is fine enough. Okay? And I already told you that if you are an, there is a further discussion in this this thing also. I've changed the slide, okay? Where we are also going to talk about that you have visible people coming in your so we are talking about planning. Huh? So see, these are the various pictures of how the racking is done. So you, in the niche wala this thing, you can see here that there is actually the first guy is not sitting on a racking. He's just sitting on a chair on a plain area and then the racking starts. So again, as I keep telling you guys, and they did this because they wanted to have balcony. Now, if suppose this racking is very high, then can you imagine library, balconies will be so high? And then probably this guy will not be able to view this because his sight line has to be controlled. Na? Agar iska sight line idhar hai, usko state dikhega hi nahi. Hai na? So that is, so the racking, guys, gives you the profile of the section of the auditorium. That's why Jimmy said that you have to plan auditorium in section. Swati, if you feel to add anything that I'm missing out, please add so. Okay. Am I clear what I'm saying? So you can see different kinds of, yahan pe pura flat hai. Yes.
Can you once repeat the distances of raking, the riser, and the eye level?
Oh, yes.
It's kind of confusing. We kept repeating.
No, it's okay. Good you are asking. I am happy. See, guys, that's what I always keep telling. I like the class which asks me questions. That means you are alive and listening to me. Anyway, I will repeat once again. So racking is basically putting chairs on the steps. Now I can design the steps 10 mm, 11 mm, 15 mm, whatever. So that is first thing. Okay. Once you do this and you put your chairs on it, you put a man or a woman on it, take an average height. Okay. And you decide the eye level. Once you decide the eye level, okay, you figure out that AX, okay, which I said thumb rule pe chalo 15 mm liya. 15 mm. Now, if you take that 15 mm, take the distance between the two steps. Abhi aapne chair rakh diya na, so now there will be another step. But you don't know how much the steps to take. You don't know. Aapko 10 lena hai ki 15 lena hai ki 11 lena hai. What will you do? You will go ulta, as I said before. Instead of designing the step first, you have put the man first. Okay, pehla row aapne design kar liya. Now you don't know whether should I take 11. Or should I take 13? You don't know. You are confused. So what you do is you put another man behind the first man on the same chair. Okay. And you put him 10 to 15 mm above. Now you want to put 10 mm, 15 mm above, whatever. Okay. Similarly, you do this. Okay. You join the line of their eyes. Okay. Or uska parallel line up join karo and then start doing the steps. You will get the size of the steps, the depth of the steps.
Thank you.
See, there are various ways it can be done. See, suppose this is only speaking wala auditorium. Jaise apne college mein hai. Our college is a flat. Na? There is no raking. Absolutely no raking. It's a flat thing. And Neel Kamal ka chair laga diya hai. Usko kapda laga ke thoda achha dikhta hai. So it's like that, you know. I mean, now, in such an area, but you know that it's essentially only the speaking stage. We don't have performances happening there. I mean, of course, the school, Samne Wala, does the performance. But theek hai, I mean. So there, you will see that most of the people does have an issue. You can see people leaning left, right, thoda sa upar dekhte hain, seedha baithte hain, taki aage wale ka thoda upar dekhenge. You will see all that issues happening there in our auditorium because it's a flat kind of a thing. Unless what we do is we project it pretty high up on the stage and behind. Then there are no issues, okay? But then the distance from the last guy who is sitting from the stage, even looking at the huge screen, sometimes the figures are not very clear. Okay, that's why when we make PPTs, we keep that, we need to be aware that what kind of font I am using. I am presently using 18 font. Now, these are all ready-made things taken from the new first. Okay, so I mean, you will get the same kind of pictures from the new first. I just wanted to explain to you. But if I am making a drawing, then I will have to see that a person who's sitting at the last is able to see me. Right now, everybody is seeing from the screen. Main 12 bhi rakhunga, so you'll be easily able to read it. But these are different times. When I plan my PPT in real class, when I know that 80th student is going to sit way away from me, and I have to assure that that guy is able. So what I'm trying to tell you is that distance is so important, where you have to see the clarity of speech, clarity of vision, sight lines, sound lines, comfort levels, everything. You know? When you plan all this, then only the auditoriums come alive. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So various kinds of these things are given where P has to be raised, okay, if racking is not done. Obviously, yeah, nobody will be able to see. Bande ko kuch dikhega hi nahi. So then that means the person, so the stage has, P is a point where a person is speaking, okay? So his speech point. Mm-hmm. So that is the thing. So obviously that has to be raised so that the people can see. When P is on stage dais, okay? So when you have this P and the stage is here and the racking is done. So there are different positions of P and stage, and then you do this niche wala is still more complex because you, and they also have planned orchestra pit here. Yeah, I mean, options are numerous, okay? Probabilities are numerous. You have to work all these geometries out by yourself, understanding the principles. That's why what we are trying to tell you here is principle of planning. Then how do you manifest that? Is something, it's like your mom must be, boys and girls, this is pandemic, so I'm sure all of you are helping your mother and father in the everywhere possible way. I'm sure some of the boys also cook, okay? Your mom will teach you, these are the principles of how to make a chapati. Ab wo chapati round hai ya square hai, swad to wahi hai na? It's a manifestation of the principle that aata lena hai aur usko belna hai. That's the principle. How the shape evolves, how फिर उसको आप कैसे सेकते हो, फिर उसको कैसे तेल लगाते हो, घी लगाते हो, बटर लगाते हो, that's completely your way of manifesting it. Okay? You have understood the principle of making chapati. Am I clear?
Is there any other rule for the balcony besides the sight line?
No. And of course, acoustic lines. Of course, acoustic lines are there. We'll study that. But acoustic lines will come in acoustics, not here.
Yeah.
So sound lines are there and sight lines are there. So sight lines plan mein bhi hota hai. Now see this. Sight lines, and I'll show you that also. The previous aage wala picture mein wahi hoga. Sight lines, there are vertical sight lines where I am able to see straight line without anybody's head or anything coming in between, or I'm seeing full of the stage. That's one way of seeing a sight line. And then I'm sitting somewhere in the auditorium, maybe at the extreme aisle on the left-hand side or right-hand side. Okay. Central wale ko issue nahi hai because they are seeing the stage very beautifully. Okay. The best seat is the central seat. But if I'm sitting on the edges, okay, like really hugging the edges, in that scenario, as I said, if your stage is not planned well, part of that shaded part of the stage, I will not see unless you plan your stage like that. Okay. So yes, I can have that issue. So there, how you plan your seat, that's why when another good point of doing round is now you are round, but the point of focus is the central point of the stage. You don't have to twist your head. Aapka positioning hi humne aise kar diya hai, you are facing the stage, okay? So that it's that way it stops the crick in your neck, okay? But imagine you are having straight kind of a seating, okay? And you have the stage. Okay, and then now you have to turn your head around 15 or 10 degrees to see the stage. That is a problem when that position stays for 3 hours. If you're watching a movie or a play, and a play is of long duration, then beech mein, I'm sure you will have to do some neck exercise. Ye given hai. You will see and you will feel, and probably you young guys will not have issues. Okay, I'm being very frank with you. But if I go and sit in an auditorium like this for in half an hour, I'll start having issues. And I did have a big issue in one of the auditorium where the seat, maybe probably my seat was bad or it was not functioning or something. But uska headdress jo tha piche was thoda lower tha. Okay? And I couldn't. You know? And by the time, and I remember which movie also, it was Avengers. Horrible movie. But anyways, I had to go because my son was so interested in that. So I went there. After that, for a week, I suffered with the back neck. Week. It was that bad seat. So seating and ergonomics are so important, even in the office and in your planning. So knowing that is extremely important. Okay. Okay. Another way of doing racking. And these are the sight lines that I was talking. Okay. The line of racking must be continuous over the... important. Okay. So what happens here is this. This is a big ditch part. Okay. Now this is it. So you suddenly have a aisle here. Okay. Ye aisle aa gaya beech mein. Now what happens is, if you don't continue this line, problem. Okay. Now see, this line, agar isko hum continue karega, ye, because of this, there will be a problem. Okay. So probably the first step has to be raised up a little bit higher, or maybe there are two steps and then you go up. So that care has to be taken. Okay. To start the rake again after the cross aisle, as shown here, results in bad sight lines for the seats immediately behind the aisle. If I continue the same, you can see this guy. He will be like on the edge of the seat, on his feet, trying to, look over the other guy because he's not able to see the stage. So you will have to take precautions here. Okay, these are the sight lines that I was talking about. Okay? So you are sitting this in a plan. Okay, this is in a plan. You are sitting here. Okay, these are the wings. See the way the positioning of the wings are so that they obstruct my view inside this area. Okay, and I get a clear idea of the stage. So what are they trying to say is, this is easy because this is the first row. But like this, this should happen also from the last row. That is the idea of this drawing, okay, where they're saying that the wings and the view, you should obstruct the wings inside view because you don't know people are, there's too much of fidgeting happening inside. Okay. There are technicians running around. Sometimes they run around with the torch if suppose it's supposed to be dark and no light from the side stage should come on the stage in such an area. Imagine if this are placed like this. Aisa rakha hai, and you are sitting here and you are able to see, oh, there is running around and then somebody is performing here. आपका ध्यान यहाँ पे नहीं जाएगा, यू विल बी डिस्ट्रैक्टेड बाय द मूवमेंट्स हियर, सो योर जॉब इज टू प्लेस द विंग्स वेरी प्रॉपरली. ओके, सो दिस वाज जस्ट अबाउट द विंग्स एंड द व्यू एंड हाउ डू यू स्टॉप द व्यू इनटू द विंग्स. ठीक है, नेक्स्ट. या सो अगेन सी 12 सेंटीमीटर, हाँ सेंटीमीटर है, ओके, हाँ दैट इज फ्रॉम द स्टेज. ओके, right? So this is how, so it's 1.10, okay, say eye level. Again, this is the same thing that I was telling you, so I will not repeat again and again the same thing, but it's exactly what they are saying. Okay. Yeah, so this is the sight vision that I was saying. So now you're sitting in plan. This was in section, so that's why if you're sitting at the balcony, you have to take this. But if you're sitting and doing it in a plan, you have to see this, okay? Now imagine if this guy is here and the stage is planned like this. The stage is planned somewhere here like this. So he will have to turn his head like this. So he will have to, now the head will be like this. You understand what I'm saying? And then he will be able to see the vision. So that's how the angle of vision. So we have done this in our, I think, 10th standard, 8th standard somewhere. That you have 30, okay, 60 is one of the good line of vision. Beyond that, you see peripheral things. You don't see real things, okay, or you don't get an idea about the correctness of the movement, or you get the correctness of the facial expressions or something like that. So this angle is very important, okay. 30 is the most important angle. 60 I will allow, okay, as a extension of 30, okay, chalega, but not very high, a good situation. But theek hai, chalega. Beyond 60, problem. I won't see anything, okay? So your job is to see how you place the seat to the stage And is my stage within my 30 degrees? So you have to take an angle of 30 degree from the guy, okay, by positioning him in such a way that he's able to see the last back wall of the stage completely. If that angle is achieved, you are fine. To give you an example, I'll draw it out for you. So if this is the part of the stage, okay, and if a person is sitting here, you will have to draw angle of 30 to see that if this is, see, this is the eye. How do you do it? So if this is the person, you see this, na, usne center mein se ye line nikala hai. And then you draw 30 degree to that. So similarly, I'll draw 30 degree. And if this is happening and my stage is within that 30 degree, you have achieved your goal. If it is not happening, that means part of the stage is not being seen. And you have to do something about it. You'll have to shift this guy inside and probably isko aisle banana padega, where people will walk. While walking, I don't need to see the stage, okay? So that's how it is. So you plan your sight lines according to this angle of 30 and how this guy is sitting here. Okay, now see, this is exactly what I was saying. Wo baitha seedha hai, lekin stage idhar hai. Okay, so abhi usko turn karna padega. So can you see how uncomfortable the position if this is a 60-year-old guy, okay? So yeah, so these are some of the things that as a planner, as an architect, you need to take care. Okay, am I clear? The sight lines?
So when we're talking about a conical auditorium, for example, usme that naturally turn towards the center of the stage anyway, right? Mm-hmm. And aage peeche, he can turn his head by 90 degrees.
Sorry. I will tell you an example before you tell me. Suppose we are sitting in our auditorium, and something is happening. Say you are sitting on the left-hand side where the door opens, okay? Aap door se andar aaye and you took a seat there. Okay, now this the whole function is happening where that dais is, where Paul khada rehke baat karta tha, you know, at the end, where that music guy sits, okay? What will you do? You will turn your chair, na? Instead of moving your head, what do? We turn our chair because hamara chair flexible hai. In this auditorium, those chairs are fixed to the ground. So, tumko mundi ghumana padega. And that is a problem. Big problem. It's really hurtful. Yeah, now you can stay.
Sorry, I was listening. I just was not happy to see because my window just suddenly started raining and pani aa gaya tha because my shutter just broken. So, I was like, unable to unmute. When I turn, so already my seat is turned, let's say, 30 degrees towards the stage, the center of the stage. Uske upar, I can turn my head up to 60 degrees. And when that 60 degrees is, or 60 degrees. Okay. And then, or can I turn 90? How much can the head turn? 90,
I am telling you, that you don't have
dukhega.
To turn the head. If you have dukhega. To turn the head, it's a bad planning.
Exactly.
This particular angle is without turning the head. I should get my stage within 30. Aray, baba, head turn karna hai, toh phir ye angle ka lafda hi nahi na.
It's
a compromise. The moment I have to turn my head, it's a compromise. And why should I plan with something compromised in mind?
Yeah.
If I'm starting right from the scratch, I will plan ki wherever I'm sitting, without turning my head, very ergonomically, comfortably, I am getting 30 degree angle, complete stage in my 30 degree. But if you do this, fantastic. Okay, you can't do 30 degrees. Manage within 60 degrees. Okay, chalega. But that is the thumb rule. Beyond that, your stage will be useless. Fir aapko head turn karna padega, and that's where ergonomically, you will not be comfortable. That's what I was trying to say. You don't have to turn head. Okay?
Yeah.
Right? Am I clear?
Permanently holding a turned head.
That's exactly what I'm saying. Permanently, you have to keep on looking there. Even if you are a young kid, you will get
tricked. That's what I was clarifying. So within that 30 degrees, so front seat, I have to manage within 60 degrees maximum.
Yep. So these are all various angles they have given. So this is the vertical angle. So yahan pe in the vertical, I have to see that my... Shit, it's so dark. I can't see my... I'll have to put on light. what happened. Okay. One second. Just give me a minute, guys. Just a minute. Yeah. I can't see my keyboard. It's so dark. Okay. So I was just saying that if this is my stage, the height, then this is what I should see. This is this vertical sight line is to see that I get to see complete that ratio, golden ratio ka jo bhi hai. I should be able to see that. Okay. If this, okay, if my stage is this, then there is a problem. That means there is a problem in the racking, and this guy is not able to see part of the stage vertically while he's sitting up there. Usko nahi dikh raha. So that is a problem. So, so this is for vertical racking. I mean, sorry, sight vision, and this is for planning when you do things in your plan. Okay, that's why they've made it like this. See, na ye wala and ye wala. Yahan pe he has to turn his head. While yahan pe kaise kiya hai? Usko bithaya hi teda. They have shifted the chair. In that round, you almost shift the chair and it faces the stage. So that's the power of planning your round this thing. I mean, but there are other ways of doing it. Like if you see Philharmonica Berlin, they have done it in a kind of offshoot way. You know, it's not round, but it's like angular. But you are still facing the stage without turning your head. And anyway, it was music. You can close your eyes and listen to music as well. So that's a different thing. But I'm just saying. Theek hai? Am I clear? Right?
Could you please explain the vertical part again? Sorry.
Yeah. Yeah. So the vertical part is, one minute. So if this person is sitting here, okay, and he's the last person, last row mein sabse upar baitha hai, okay, theek hai? Now, if his line of vision, is obstructed by the stage, meaning now he's not able to see part of what is happening here because he's above the stage, or maybe the stage is here. Uska mundi stage ke upar hai. His head is above the stage. See na, uska line of vision kitna cut hoga. All this part of the stage he will not see. Probably you have planned some beautiful lights up there. Okay, or maybe some reflection is happening up there. You have planned all that. Okay, generally aisa hota nahi hai. But I'm saying you have planned it because maybe the show designed it like that. Okay, now in such a scenario, person who's sitting on the last tracking, say a balcony, and is not able to view the stage, or the stage ka proscenium is not making it. So basically, when I do this, okay, my intention is of drawing it like this, is that if this is, okay, if this is it, okay, when I do the stage, aage ka to dikhega, that is not a problem, that's okay, that is easy, but what is not able to see is this part, the back side of the stage, and that is where your depth of the stage will matter. And so I cannot compromise on the depth of the stage now, because abhi Shamak Davar needs that bigger stage, I have to provide him. What I can do is I can work on my racking and I can work on his sight lines. That is in your hand.
Okay, understood. Yeah, thank you.
Yeah. So that golden ratio 1.6 is to 1 has to be followed, and based on that you will design your stage. Once the stage is up, you will then take care of your sight lines, okay, vertically as well as horizontally. Are we clear? Can I go to the next slide? Any questions here? What is the time? I hope I'm not
Meenal, I have a question. How many rows do you need to consider before putting cross aisles, like these number of standard rows after every cross aisle?
As I said, that's why they've given meters. 24 meters is comfortable for playhouse. But a person is very commercially minded. Wo bolega 24 meters bolta hoga, lekin main to TV lagane wala hu. Let me give 50 meters. Kya farak padta? There are no constraints in that. I mean, if it's a large site, I will have a very large auditorium. But it won't be an auditorium where I am able to, assure people of quality when they sit at the back, because they are not able to see things on the stage. Mera eye ka limitation hai. 24 ke baad, यू विल नॉट बी एबल टू जज द फेशियल एक्सप्रेशंस एंड वो भी तुम्हारी एज का बाय द टाइम यू रीच माय एज ओके एंड पीपल ऑफ माय एज वी विल नीड स्पेक्स एंड इवन देन प्रोबेबली वी विल नॉट सी सो या आई मीन इट्स एन आई साइट प्रॉब्लम सो देर आर नो लिमिट्स लाइक दैट they've given that's why I mentioned that limit 24 meter pehle hi mention kar diya beyond that is your question and your issue
Meenal
mm-hmm.
so after within 24 25 meters how many times do we have to provide the cross aisle is it like after every few rows of seats
aisa kuch nahi hai No, no, no. Nothing like that. In fact, if you see, cross aisle are generally when the entrances happen and cross aisle. Otherwise, people don't even keep cross aisle. They would have longitudinal aisles facing the stage. Okay. And if there are exits, generally, suppose you have planned exit, it's a small auditorium, right? Aapne ek end mein exit kiya hai, front mein exit kiya hai. Why will you need a cross aisle? But if you have a large auditorium and you have like multiple exits happening, so to reach that exit, I need a cross aisle. There you will put a cross aisle. Yeah. So there are no norms ki 7 ke baad ek cross aisle chahiye, iske baad ek cross aisle chahiye. Because cross aisle is a problem in racking. I will want to not have cross aisle as much as possible. But where safety is concerned, to hell with racking. Believe me, guys, this is exactly the sentiments of planners. That if I have to protect my 1,000 people sitting in Bhaidas Hall, by the way, has a capacity of 900 people. If I have to protect the life of 900 people, I can, if I have to compromise, I'll compromise on racking, but not on cross aisle. Because I have to make them go to the exit door. Then you provide cross aisle and do the necessary steps of raising the rack to get the correct sight lines. Got it?
Yeah, thank you.
So what I'll do na, I like these questions that you guys are throwing. What I'll do is I'll collect numerous plans. I have case studies, but I don't know whether they have proper plans or not, but maybe I can collect few plans and we can discuss plans, okay? Where we can discuss all these planning things that we are just going by, you know? We can do that. Yeah, so can I go ahead? We are on slide number 12. I have 6 more to go. Okay, this is the tiered sitting and the wheelchair space proportion. Portion. So now see, yes.
Can we continue in the next class if it's possible? Because we have 80, so the break will go very short.
Is the time? I have no idea about the time.
It's already 12:35.
Oh, sorry. Okay, so we'll do that. We can continue next time. No problem. Yeah?
Thank you.
Yeah, right.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye. Thank you.